everyone. My name is Anna Babarinde, and I'm the coordinator for science education in Sonoma County in California. And I'm coming to you from my house in Petaluma, California. Today, we're going to do a roller coaster engineering challenge. You'll get a series of five challenges, and you complete as many of them as you want using some simple household materials that I'll go through with you in a minute. The challenges get more and more complex, and the goal in each of them is that your roller coaster car, which is either a marble or a bouncy ball, doesn't fly off of your track and doesn't crash at the end. Good luck. One of the main materials that you need is either pipe insulation, which you can get at any hardware store, or you can use pool noodles, which you can find at a number of stores, including Target. And what you want to do, and you need a grown-up to help with this part, is you'll take the pool noodle or the pipe insulation and then use something like a box cutter to cut it in half so that you have two equal pieces. And then you can use scissors to trim off any extra pieces that are left over. The other items that you'll need for the challenge are a cup. It can be plastic, it can be paper, it can be a real cup. Try not to use glass. And then masking tape. You'll measure out 2 feet of masking tape. Cardstock, you can use regular paper if you don't have that, and you decide. For myself, I'm saying that my 2 pieces of cardstock are 2 half pieces. You can choose whether you want whole or half pieces. And then you'll need either a marble or a bouncy ball. So in this case, I have this bouncy ball. It's a little chick in honor of Easter. Now, if you're choosing a bouncy ball, then you want to make sure that it's a small one, because I tried a big one earlier and it doesn't work very well. So your first challenge is just to make a regular roller coaster. It doesn't have to be anything fancy, but your car has to be able to ride it the whole way without flying off, and it can't fly off or crash at the end. It has to have a soft landing. So let's try it and see how we do.
Mia, what do you think about the roller coaster?
I have my pool noodle grounded on the top of a stool. You can use anything in the kitchen as long as it's safe. And then partway down where it gets really steep, I use the cardstock to make a tunnel in case it starts to jump off the track at all. And then as I go down towards the bottom, I taped on a cup so that it's grounded at the end and it softens the ending for the car. Let's try it out. I have found that using the slow-mo feature on the phone is really helpful as I try out my track, because then I can analyze exactly what's happening. What I noticed when I looked at mine is that the car did jump a little bit on the track, and then at the end, it landed in the cup, and that did soften the ending, but the cup separated from the rest of it, and the tape broke. So what I need to do is go back and fix some of those things, make it a safer ride for the car. Once I've done that, I'm going to try it 3 times and make sure that I have success 3 times in a row. And once that's true, I can move on to the next challenge. Now, the one that I did is really basic. I know that you guys can come up with much more creative things. A couple of constraints for you. First of all, you can use all 4 of your pool noodles or pipe insulation pieces at once, but you can't cut them at all. You have to use them as is. Second, you can reuse the tape and the cardstock, but you don't get new tape and cardstock for the next challenge. You have to use the same ones for all 5 challenges. So make sure you use them sparingly and cut them in a way that you can repurpose them. We can't wait to see what you come up with, so please share all of your ideas, and good luck to you all. Thanks so much for being here.